All right, here we go. Coming up next, a lightweight championship fight between Khabib Nurmagomedov and Justin Gaethje. The most exciting man in mixed martial arts today. My fantasy football team is Team Gaethje. Justin Gaethje, since signing with the UFC a few years ago, has absolutely taken this promotion by storm.
And he's only in main events. He's only in main events because you know, when you put Justin Gaethje at the top of the marquee, people will show up to watch in the arena, but they will also tune in on their television sets, on their computers and laptops, on your PS4 or your Xbox, regardless of the console, people will show up to watch Justin Gaethje fight. All action fighter, has great wrestling, but it's his boxing and his leg kicks that has truly made him special to fight fans all around the world.
Well, in a division as talented as 155 pounds, it is absolutely remarkable what this man has accomplished. Here he is, folks, the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world. Now, his goals, far more lofty than that. The title defenses are starting to pile up, but he believes with this type of challenger that has some momentum with fight fans, if he can dust this guy here tonight, he can take his career to the next level and start to be mentioned with the GOATs, the Hall of Fame types. For now, he'll have to settle for UFC lightweight champion. We will see how it goes for him tonight, Vinks. Tale of the tape for this lightweight fight. Both fighters are 31. Gaethje is 1 inch taller. The reach is the same. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Yves Loving. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC Lightweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 22 wins, 3 losses. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Introducing the challenger, Justin the Highlight Gaethje. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a grappler, holding a professional record of 29 wins, no losses. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of the Republic of Dagestan, Russia, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world, Khabib the Eagle.
UFC belt on the line, guys. Protect yourself at all time. Obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now. Go back to your corner.
So here we go with round one, and when you have what looks like a classic matchup of striker versus grappler, it doesn't always play out that way, but given what these fighters said to us on Thursday, the game plans seem pretty clear.
They're very clear game plans, but which one of them is able to implement the game plan most effectively? The grappler will try to get forward, get close, try to secure takedowns. He's even willing to pull guard to make sure that he is in the grappling situation. The striker needs to stay at space. The striker needs to maintain distance and fight behind that beautiful jab he possesses. Big, hard punch lands. Now he gets back to Reign.
Well, if you like Muay Thai striking, this might be your moment in this fight as he gets the Thai clinch.
This is a massive moment for this fighter. He is a great Muay Thai fighter. Look for him to go knee-knee and then try to land a big one to the head.
Oh! Big shots exchanged in the pocket there. And they separate. So there's that takedown defense on full display yet again. It's held up for him.
He does a fantastic job of squaring up his hips, getting his legs back, and understanding not to allow his opponent to get going on his takedown finish.
So just over 20 total strikes now for Justin Gaethje. Gaethje gets caught with that punch. He's treading water now. Got to find a way to move those feet. Stuffs that takedown attempt without issue. And they separate. Oh, beautiful jab there, man. It's like you know what's coming. Is that one appear to stun?
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Well, you start to really worry about the wrestling, and there's that left hand from Cubby.
Underrated. I mean, it's a very
nice liver shot, Lance. Now goes in and secures the takedown. All right, good movement by him here on the ground. He really is a master of these transitions.
He is a master of movement.
Oh, he's got a lot of different arm bars he can go to attacking here.
And attacking armbar.
Continuing to try to manipulate the head here. And this might just be a matter of time. Tonight, champ.
He does a great job of staying patient. He doesn't rush or panic. You are never safe when you're fighting this guy. You're in a lot of trouble. You're in a lot of trouble the entire time when you're this good in the submission.
So there is the man they are all chasing at 155 pounds, the undisputed UFC lightweight champion. And how about the way he got it done tonight? A spectacular submission to finish the job.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Yves LeMing has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 32 seconds in the very first round. Declared the winner by tap out due to an arm bar and still.
The still UFC lightweight champion of the world. A lot of steam here during fight week that maybe there were a few things that could plague him tonight. Looked as good as ever from under.
He looked as good as he's ever looked inside the octagon. He's so good at everything, every single skill that you need to become champ. He has mastered, and he showed it in this fight.